Welcome to the Bible study. Okay, so Isaiah 20, more rebel saints. Here we go. Not even lost in translation. It's right there, but like a big dysfunctional family, false religion just reads over it and goes right into denial about the whole thing as if the saints weren't totally cool. Okay, here we go. Isaiah 20, verse 1. In the year that Tartan came unto Ashdod, when Sargon, the king of Assyria sent him and fought against Ashdod and took it, at the same time spake the Lord by Isaiah the son of Amoz, saying, go and loose the sackcloth from off thy loins, and put off thy shoe from thy foot. And he did so, walking naked and barefoot. What? That's an obedient servant, and quite a rebel. And the Lord said, like as my servant Isaiah hath walked naked and barefoot, just in case you didn't get it, 3 years. So it wasn't just one day. It was like, oh, I haven't heard from God to put on any clothes, so enjoy, everybody. And the Lord said, like as my servant Isaiah hath walked naked and barefoot 3 years for a sign and wonder upon Egypt and upon Ethiopia, so shall the king of Assyria lead away the Egyptian prisoners and the Ethiopians captives, and young and old, naked and barefoot, even with their buttocks uncovered to the shame of Egypt. So what's going to be a punishment for others? Why would God do that? I don't know. Maybe something's messed up in translation. Or maybe somebody needs to go naked for 3 years. Unless God didn't tell them to do so. I don't know. Now, this does sound wild to us. And it is, because we're so uptight and we're so far away from the word that we swear to, you know, believe in, and they kiss it before Mass at the most, you know, hypocritical church of all, the Church of the Child Molestation. It's disgusting. Anyway, don't send your kids to that church. Otherwise, you are tithing into child molesters. I mean, change it. Say that their little boys should not be alone with alcohol, with guys pretending like they've given up sex and are all repressed and unhealthy about it. The same guys they had to confess to about their sexual feelings, and don't tell kids they can't touch themselves, so that, you know, they're like a ticking time bomb. And when a priest comes by and they're drinking together, and, you know, it's just a setup for child molestation, and it's wrong. And to keep relocating them is just criminal. But when they allow women to be ministers and they don't isolate men and they don't allow your children to be with alcohol with these men in the same changing rooms, and if you teach your children it's okay to touch yourself, you know, just when you're alone, and make sure to clean up after yourself, and, you know, they're way less desperate. And so anyway, just a suggestion. All right, my darlings. Right. Yeah, a friend of mine who's a minister's son said, you know, nowhere in the Bible does it say not to masturbate. And what they take out of context is, it is better to cast your seed in the belly of a whore than to cast it on the ground. Now, maybe that's just God's way of saying, don't litter, you know, just clean up after yourself. But I think it's way better to touch yourself than to promote prostitution as a business, false religion. You disgusting human traffickers and rapists. You are disgusting. Let people touch themselves, and then they can choose who to be with, who they love, and not out of desperation, and leave the kids alone, and let your priest be married like you did for the first 1,000 years till 1099 in the Catholic Church. Duh. And you want to make sure there's no child molestation? Okay, well then keep a video camera going in the changing room. There shouldn't even be a changing room with kids and men that pretend that they've given up sex, you know. Alcohol. Why is it that kids are allowed to have alcohol if they're part of the Catholic Church? That's a big scandal right there. Anyway, speaking the truth, because I got Jesus and he loves you. Praise the Lord. This is only for those with ears to hear and eyes to see, not for those with a really bad fashion sense, like, my gosh, what those priests wear. They're hideous. Oh my God. Even when they get the shoes done by Prada, they miss the mark. No fashion sense, those hypocritical Christians, like those TV evangelists, like Donald Trump, like, you know, anyway, I'm just stating that's just the truth and the truth sets us free. I can't lie. I'm a real Christian and God is truth. Praise the Lord. No phoniness here.